to the Mount Olive AME Zion Church, where we are advancing the kingdom of God by making disciples. Thank you for joining us. We pray that you will be encouraged by the word that is shared on today. At the end of the message, we will provide you more information on how to connect with our church. Be blessed.
Hello, beloved. My name is Pastor Kelsey Hopson. Thank you for joining with us. We have been experiencing for over a year now some isolation and even some disconnectedness. But guess what? God created us for community, formed us for fellowship, and it is good when we dwell together in unity. And so we don't want to wait until we fully re-enter into our buildings and we're able to experience some sense of normalcy to begin to cultivate connection, to strengthen fellowship. Yes, 2020-21 conference year, our focus has been strengthening the fellowship. And so guess what? We don't want to wait later, but we want to start now to cultivate connection. In other words, we want to stress the fact that we're better together. And so this month, we're going to deal with worship, it's better together. Discipleship, it's better together. Stewardship, it's better together. Last but not least, leadership, especially in this season, it's better together. And so we hope that you would take out the time to join with us for manna in May. Guess what? We are better together.
Northeastern Episcopal District Annual Conference 2021 will be held on June 18th and 19th. Service will begin at 7 p.m. via Zoom. On May 22nd and 23rd, we will celebrate Reverend Kelsey Hopson's Pastor Appreciation. On Saturday, May 22nd, from 1 to 2:30, we will have a drive-through appreciation. Drive through and greet the pastor. Gifts may be presented at this time. Enter from Bishop Street and exit Pearl Street. On Sunday, May 22nd, 11 a.m., YouTube, we will have the appreciation service with guest speaker, Reverend Dr. Dwayne L. Tutt. Our theme is Leadership is Better Together.
News first, fellowship and prayer with the pastor. Every Tuesday at 1 p.m. via conference call. Prayer every Wednesday at 11:30 a.m. Bible study every Wednesday at 12 noon and 6 p.m. via Zoom and conference call. Sunday school every Sunday at 9:30 a.m. via conference call. Class leaders meeting is every second and fourth Monday at 1 p.m. Please govern yourselves accordingly and have a blessed week.
Hello, beloved. We are excited again about this day. We have a guest preacher that's going to deliver the third installment of our four-part sermon series, Better Together. We have Reverend Dr. Eric Leake with us. Reverend Leake, he was born in Troy, North Carolina, raised in Mount Gilead, North Carolina. And at the age of 21, he preached his trial sermon in 1985. When appointed to Greater Warner Tabernacle AME Zion Church in Knoxville, Tennessee, the Lord directed him divinely to lead this congregation and the community in revitalization and renewal for more than 16 years. And then in 2016, he was appointed to serve in Chicago, Illinois, at Martin Temple AME Zion Church, where he currently serves. He received Bachelor of Science from Shaw University, the Master of Divinity degree from Hood Theological Seminary in 1995, and Doctor of Ministry degree from United Theological Seminary in 2004. He is prepared for ministry and equipped for the work. He serves as president and CEO of the Martin Temple Community Foundation, prayer coordinator and director of evangelism for the Midwest Episcopal District, and he serves on the board of the Church Growth and Development for the AME Zion Church and the international prayer coordinator for our denomination. He's the author of the workbook, Making a Comeback, and the book, Praying on Purpose. He's committed to the community. He's connected to the church, and he's married to the former Jean McMurray. They have four children, and he is a candidate for the office of bishop in the AME Zion Church. And so we look forward to the ways in which God is going to use this man of God to deliver a word. Get ready.
Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Greetings to the family of God at the Mount Olive AME Zion Church in Waterbury, Connecticut. To Pastor Kelsey Hopkins and First Lady Hopkins, and to all of you God's children, I greet you with Jesus' joy. Thank you, Pastor Hopkins, for giving me this rare and wonderful privilege of sharing with you all today in your worship celebration. Let us pray. Spirit of God, we pray now that your word will go forth. We pray that your people will be blessed. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray that you will give us eyes to see, ears to hear, hearts to obey, and minds to understand. In Jesus' name we thank you, and in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. For the time that is mine today, I want to share with you from the theme, Stewardship is Better Together. I'd like to call your attention to two scriptures. The first is 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 10. And the second is 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 6 through 8. 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 10. As each one has received a gift, minister it to one another as good stewards of the manifold grace of God. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 6 through 8. But this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. So let each one give as he purposes in his heart, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you, always having all sufficiency in all things, may have an abundance for every good work. Stewardship is better together. Pastor Rick Warren writes in the book, 40 Days of Community, which started out as Better together. In the 40 days of community, the design is to deepen the understanding of how God uses community for our own good and growth, as well as to help us cultivate deeper relationships with those around us. We learn to fulfill God's purposes and discover how we are better together. According to Pastor Warren, we are better together because we are compelled to love God's family. We are commissioned to reach out together. We are chosen to fellowship together. We are connected to grow together. We are called to serve together. And we are created to worship together. Some things are simply better together. You know, like peanut butter and jelly, salt and pepper, bat and ball, cornbread and greens, a pair of socks, a pair of gloves, a pair of shoes, a pair of cufflinks, pen and paper, soap and water, knowledge and powder, knowledge and power, better together. Solomon even teaches us in Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verses 9 through 12, that two are better than one because they have a good reward for their labor. For if they fall, one will lift up the other, his companion. But woe to him who is alone when he falls, for he has no one to lift him up. Again, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one be warm alone? Though one may be overpowered by another, two can withstand him. And a threefold cord is not quickly broken. Yes, we are better together. So as you have journeyed this month on being better together, the task that is mine today is to remind us that stewardship truly is better together. Stewardship is being a faithful steward and caretaker of what belongs to God. Taking care of God's property, God's people, through time, temple, treasures, and talents for God's glory. How we care for what God has entrusted to us determines often what we really think about God. Stewardship is more than about money, but it includes money. There are three things about stewardship today that I would like to establish as we move into this message. The first thing I want to establish is that God owns it all. God owns it all. The second thing, we are all stewards. And thirdly, we have a responsibility to manage it for God's glory. In the text, 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 10, Peter reminds us that we are ministers and servants because we have been given gifts. Peter is concerned about ministry. He speaks in his writing about how serious it is to be watchful, prayerful, practicing hospitality, and above all things, fervent in our love with one another. In verse 10, he shifts his focus to ministry in the body of Christ. He offers a clear and practical approach that will help us to understand how stewardship is better together. He notes that each one of us has received a gift and that we all have something to offer. Then the Apostle Paul will help us to understand the sharing of our treasures in 2 Corinthians to match the ministry and the gifts that we've been called to. And so, as we navigate through these verses, I would like to offer you three things where we are better together with stewardship. Stewardship of our talents is better together. Stewardship of our time is better together. And stewardship of our treasures is better together. First of all, stewardship of our talents is better together. As I speak of talents, I'm ultimately going to refer you to spiritual gifts. Peter says, as each one has received a gift. We have all received gifts from God, gifts and talents. Using often our God-given talents and spiritual gifts to bring glory to God and to build up the body of Christ. We are born with talent. We can be trained for certain skills and talent. But when we are born again, we get spiritual gifts. Many times the Holy Spirit can use our talents and our gifts together to enhance the work of ministry. The gift that Peter is speaking of is like an endowment from the Holy Spirit to operate according to the gifts that have been deposited in us. When we come to fully understand the nature, the diversity, and the gifts of the Holy Spirit operating in the church, we will surely be better together. Everyone has received at least one gift in the body of Christ. And I want to make it clear, warming the pews and doing nothing in the kingdom is certainly not a spiritual gift. All gifts are needed. All gifts are important. The Corinthian church had to understand this and be delivered from prominence over importance, dominance over inclusion, and celebrity status over servanthood. God has uniquely designed, equipped, and empowered the church so that everything we need is in the body of Christ when we come together. Many gifts, one Spirit. Many ministries, but one Lord. Many activities, but the same God works in each of them. The Lord never gives anything everything. He never gives all of us all of it. He leaves enough lacking in each of us so that we can depend on him and each other, which makes us better together. One person or gift cannot build a church. One Spirit works through many to get the job done. No one in the body is more significant than another. There may be more popular or prominent roles, gifts, or influence, but in the household of faith, not one of us is more significant than the other. And so operating in our gifts makes us better together. The assignment or office that one has may be more crucial, but the Holy Spirit is operative and at work in all of our lives as much as we allow the Holy Spirit to be. Every gift is important. And when all the gifts of the Holy Spirit are in operation, there will be no lack in the body, which makes us better stewards together. What makes our spiritual gifts functional is when we use them together. Because ministry has no place for lone rangers. Therefore, when we use our spiritual gifts and our talents, it makes us better together. Secondly, stewardship of our time is better together. Stewardship of our time is better together. Note what else Peter says in verse 10. Minister it to one another as good stewards of the manifold grace of God. That as we've received the gift, We ought to use it. And part of our time that God gives us each day to minister to one another as good stewards of the manifold grace of God. While we do not neglect our private and personal time with the Lord, it is important that the saints spend time with each other. We've discovered during COVID-19 how important it is for us to stay connected to one another and to use our time to build up one another. Peter, in this text, refers to minister to one another. The word minister in the Greek is diakono, which means to serve or to minister. The purpose of spiritual gifts is to be used in our time in ministry for one another. We become stewards of the manifold grace of God. Gifts we have, we do not own, but we are stewards of the gifts and the grace of God that has been deposited to us. We learn to live and love through the grace and favor of God in our lives. Our ultimate purpose is to please the Master because we no longer belong to ourselves, but to the Lord. Part of our responsibility as stewards is to spend time with each other, offering love and grace to one another. And the other part of our time should be spent ministering to others in the body of Christ in prayer, in study, and in ministry. Spending time together in prayer, praying for one another, praying for others, praying for our families, praying for our communities, praying for your pastor and your pastor's family, praying for the congregation, the country, and the world. As we spend time together in prayer, it reminds us of the words of Jesus that where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them. It will help us strengthen our bond with each other and with the Lord. It is important in times like these that we spend time together in prayer. Then we want to spend time together in the Word, studying God's Word together, growing in the grace and in the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. As we spend time together in Bible study, Sunday school, worship, and other spiritual growth events, however we choose to do it in these times, we get the opportunity to minister to one another, to testify to one another with how the Lord has blessed us and how we encourage one another. And then not only do we want to spend time in prayer together and spend time in study together, but we want to spend time in service together. There are so many ways that we can share our time together in serving one another and those who are in need. As we spend time together in evangelism, in outreach, in encouragement, and in so many other ways, we grow, but we reach so many more people when we do it together. We can do together far more than what any of us can do alone. When we spend time together in prayer, in study, in worship, in service, and in ministry, we are better together. Consider every member being a minister, offering ministry to one another, offering grace to one another, and offering it to those in need. Then we will certainly be better together. Better together. Stewardship is better together with our talents. Stewardship is better together with our time. And finally, stewardship of our treasures is better together. Stewardship of our treasures is better together. Journey with me to 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 6 through 8. Here's what the Apostle Paul says. But this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. So let each one give as they purpose in their hearts, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you, having all sufficiency in all things, may have an abundance for every good work. Paul reminds us here of sowing and reaping. Giving is a seed, and how we give determines how we reap. We are called to give generously and cheerfully. And in fact, that word cheerful in the Greek is hilarious. That we ought to be overflowing with joy as we give, because God loves a cheerful giver. We are never more like God than we are when we give, because giving is the very nature and character of God. We are stewards of God's grace and God's gifts, but we are also stewards of God's generosity. As we spend time together with our talents and spiritual gifts in prayer, in study, in worship, and in ministry, we pool our financial resources together to do service and ministry in the kingdom of God, to advance God's kingdom. I recognize that we can get more done together when we pool our resources than we will ever get done with just resources in a single household. Now, don't get me wrong, I recognize that there are exceptions, but for most of us, it's the norm. We are called to be good stewards, not just with our talents and our time together, but also our treasures. The Lord provides for his work through us, through tithes, through offerings, and sacrificial giving. When we put our resources together, the question is never, can we afford it, but does God want us to do it? Because God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you, having all sufficiency in all things, may have an abundance for every good work. That as we pool our resources, the Lord will provide more and more. The more seeds we plant, the greater the harvest. The Lord will supply in everything, always, in all sufficiency and abundance for every good work. That the work the Lord has called us to do as the people of God, he will provide all that is needed. Perhaps that's why the song says you can't be God's giving. No matter how you try, the more you give, the more he gives to you. Just keep on giving, because his word is true. You can't beat God's giving. He gives good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall men fill your bosoms. Why? Because giving of our financial resources to the work of ministry is better together. A little girl stood near a small church from which she had been turned away because it was too crowded. I can't go to Sunday school, she sobbed to the pastor as he walked by. Seeing her shabby, unkempt appearance, the pastor guessed the reason and, taking her by the hand, took her inside the church and found a place for her in Sunday school. The child was so touched that she went to bed that night thinking of the children who have no place to worship Jesus. About 2 years later, this child lay dead in one of the poor tenement buildings, and the parents called for the kind-hearted pastor who had befriended their daughter to handle the funeral arrangements. As her body was being moved, a worn and crippled purse was found, which seemed to have been rummaged from some trash dump. Inside was 57 cents and a note scribbled in childish handwriting, which read, "This is to help build the little church bigger so more children can go to Sunday school." For 2 years, she had saved for this love offering. When the pastor tearfully read the note, he knew instantly what he would do. Carrying the note and the cracked red pocketbook to the pulpit, he told the story of her unselfish love and devotion. He challenged his deacons to get busy and raise enough money for a larger building. But the story does not end there. A large newspaper learned of the story and published it. It was read by a realtor who offered them a parcel of land worth many thousands of dollars. When told the church could not pay so much, he offered it to them for 57 cents. Church members made large donations. Checks came from far and wide. Within 5 years, the little girl's 57 cents gift had increased to $250,000, a huge sum for that time near the turn of the century. Her selfish love had paid large dividends. Then that caring pastor named Russell H. Conwell became the founder of what we know as Temple University in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. The little girl's name was Hattie Mae Wyatt, who died in 1886 in a sermon on December the 1st, 1912, which honored Hattie. Dr. Conwell reminded his congregation of the impact of that 57 cents. "Think of this large church," he wrote. "Think of the membership it has added to over 5,600 since that time. Think of the institutions that have been founded. Think of the Samaritan Hospital and the thousands of sick people who have been cured and the thousands of poor who have been ministered to every year. Think of how the Wyatt House, by which 54 cents of the 57 cents was used to make the first payment, were begun in the very first classes of Temple College." He said, if God can do that with 57 cents, think of what he can do with $5.70, $57, $570, or even $5,700. When we use the tool of treasure, of money that God has provided and give, we don't give it to programs. We don't give it to buildings. We give it to the cause. We give it to the cause of God, that we are better together when we put our resources together, because the truth is God is not broke. God is not poor. And God is not bankrupt. Where God guides, he provides. If it's his will, it's his bill. If it's his choice, it's his invoice. God will never give you a vision without provisions. If he ordered it, he can fund it. He can finance it. God has a million and one ways to bless you. If we come together and do the will of God with our talents, with our time, and with our treasures, we will discover that the glory of God will fall upon our churches, upon our families, our households, and even our communities. And so whatever it is the Lord has blessed you with, when we put it together, he ultimately calls us to be faithful, faithful stewards, faithful of our talents and our gifts, faithful of our time, faithful with our treasures. Because when we are faithful, we know that we're doing it it for the glory of God. And so I want to encourage you that you do it together. Stewardship is better together. Giving is better together. Gifts are better together. Time is better together. And may you so join together in a spirit of love, harmony, unity, and grace, that when your day is done and when your race is run, you can stand before the Lord and hear him say, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant. You've been faithful over a few things. Enter thou into the joy of the Lord, and I will make you ruler over many." Yes, by God's grace and the power of the Holy Spirit, we are better together with our talents, with our time, and with our treasures. Stewardship is better together. Amen. Amen, amen. Let us pray. Thank you, Lord, for your generosity. You've been generous to all of us. You've been generous with our treasures and our gifts. You've been generous in giving us time. And you've been generous in giving us treasures. Help us to be better stewards of that which you have entrusted to each of us. May we join together in a spirit of unity. Make us one, one heart, one flame to proclaim your name. Lord, make us one so that we are better together as we seek to steward the gifts, the ministry, the mission, and the message to advance your kingdom. Thank you for Pastor Kelsey Hopkins and the Mount Olive AME Zion Church. Bless them. Use them so that they might come to be a congregation who is fully aware that by your grace, they are better together. In Jesus' name, we thank you. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 God bless you and thank you for your time. Peace and blessings.
So we thank the Reverend Dr. Leake for that word. Stewardship, it is better together. Our talents, better together. Using our time, it's better together. Our treasure, God's treasure, given to us alone, it's better together. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Lord, we love you and we thank you, Lord, for stewardship. The earth and everything in it, it belongs to you. Lord God, our bodies belongs to you. Our life belongs to you, Lord God. Lord, and so we pray that we would be faithful stewards, that we would manage faithfully, Lord God, all that you have entrusted to us, Lord God, that is in our care, oh God. Lord, give us the courage and give us the wisdom, Lord God. Lord, to be good stewards, all to your glory, oh God. Lord God, we thank you for life. Lord, we thank you for the gift of salvation that you offer to all people, Lord God. Lord, and so help us, Lord, to be a good steward of the truth, Lord God, of the gospel of your great salvation, Lord God. Lord, right now, and if there's anyone under the sound of my voice, Lord God, who don't know you and the forgiveness of sins, the pardoning of sins, Lord God, Lord, we pray right now, Lord God, that those individuals would turn from self and sin and turn to you, oh God. Lord, we pray for salvation in the name of Jesus. We pray sanctification in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Lord, we thank you that the work that you began, that you're going to finish it to the day of Christ. Lord God, for all of us, Lord God, we want to hear those words, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant, for thou hast been faithful over a little. Come on up, and I'll make you ruler over much." Lord God, we love you. We thank you, Lord. These and other blessings we ask, and we do give thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, beloved. Have a wonderful week.
Be blessed.
Be encouraged. Be encouraged. Thank you for joining us today. You can connect in the following ways. Our Sunday morning worship at 11 a.m. via Facebook at Mount Olive, Waterbury, Connecticut, or our YouTube channel, Mount Olive AME Zion Church, or our website, MountOliveAMEZ.org, or you can simply use the dial-in number 339-207-6251. We also invite you to be a part of our midweek Bible study on Wednesdays at 12 p.m. and 6 p.m. You can connect with us via Zoom. The connection can be found on our Facebook page, or you can dial in at the same number, 339-207-6251. We have prayer at 11:30 a.m. and 5:30 p.m. You can call in using the dial-in number. Check our Facebook page for information and links. We also encourage you to invite a friend. If you desire to make a donation, simply go to our website, or you can download the Giblify app and search for Mount Olive AME Zion Church. Again, thank you for tuning in. Hope we connect again.